they're drinking tea, they're talking to each other and chatting. And at some point you say to them, right, Kate, what I'd like you to do is sit down and draw a picture.
Why is the rich picture important?
Ah, that's a good question.
It's a big sheet of paper on the middle of the table, and that's empty. Unfailingly, somebody in that group will pick up the pen and make a mark on the paper. They may draw a stick person in the middle, which represents themselves, and they may put a question mark over their heads to say, I've got no idea what I'm doing.
And people start to connect with one another and have new ideas and see things they didn't see before.
Thick lines mean things, yes? They radiate noise and bandwidth.
The image has a power to convey.
Meanings, it would be non-verbal communication through icons, feelings, emotions.
The pen and the written language brings with it all the conventions. This word means that, this word connects with these other words in these kinds of ways.
You can see in the small child walking away or the downcast head so many things that picture will tell you if you just take a few seconds to look at it.
It's a tool that can aid the thinking process.
People will say things like, I haven't done this since I was 10, you know.
Gradually more strokes appear on the page. The paper starts to fill, deepen, strengthen, elaborate.
And you become more human. You become more another human being, kind of struggling to articulate some world that you inhabit or you see.
Lots of different people, collaborative art, trying to depict a situation or a problem from many different perspectives.
It's a narrative. The picture is a narrative. And a third person looking in could almost instantly get it.
Get more from the Open University. Check out the links on screen now.